Shalom. Let me start by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak Wadash, the Baalim, City Apostles, and others of great millstone, peace and mercy to the house of David. Yahweh is the true name of the Heavenly Father, who the world calls God. Yahweh Shai is the true name of the Heavenly Father's only begotten Son, who the world refers to as Jesus Christ. Bahashem is in the name, and Rakak Wadash is the Holy Spirit. Also, shalom to the 144,000 men that's laboring this truth for the sake of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And shalom to the innumerable multitude of men, women, and children that may be listening in all truth and in sincerity. Shalom. This is your brother Kodash coming back here with another video through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And the title of this video, Lord willing, is going to be, this is where wisdom kicks in. All right. And, this happened on a Sunday, I guess before that that Miami Dolphins football game. Tyreek Hill, he got arrested, and if you watch the video, I'm not gonna have the video here, you know, but if you go on Instagram, you can, or any social media site, even YouTube, you know, you can see the video, because they released the body cam of when he was arrested. You know, he was acting proud. You know, he wasn't agreeing with the adversary. He was trying to act like he runs stuff, you know, but at the end of the day, Jake, we don't run nothing, man. Okay, we're under the curses. You know, he got treated as a nigga, man. All right, but just because you got money, you think that you can move a certain way in this world, you can't. Because at the end of the day, you're under the curses, man. And you're Israelite, you know, and you need to repent, you know. But this is Matthew 5:25. Agree with thine adversary quickly whilst thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officers, and thou be cast into prison. All right, you know, so you have to agree with your adversary. You know, when you get pulled over, listen to what they say. Do what they ask you to do, you know. You know, and then, you know, the Lord have mercy on you, man. You know, Lord willing. You know, but you trying to fight and combat with them, all right, that's going to lead you, all right, you can be even shot down. That's why a lot of these jakes get shot down, because they try to show that pride. But this is this is Sirach or Ecclesiastes 9:13. Keep thee far from the man that have power to kill. You know, and what these police officers have, they have that power to kill. They have the gun, you know, and that puffs them up. You see, it says, so shalt thou not doubt the fear of death, and if thou come unto him, make no fault, lest he take away thy life presently. You see, make no fault, man. Agree with them, man. Agree with thine adversary, man. See, he got thrown down to the ground. He looking, he gets shot, you know. It says, remember that thou goest in the midst of snares, and that thou walkest upon the battlements of the city. You see? So, you know, that's where wisdom kick in. Right? Scripture's speaking about wisdom meeting us at every thought. Every situation that we're in, you know, you should be thinking unto wisdom. It's not the one that I wanted, but just read this. Is Wisdom of Solomon 7:15. The Most High have granted me to speak as I would, and to conceive as is meet for the things that are given me, because it is he that leadeth unto wisdom and directeth the wise. All right.
But give me 1 second here. Wisdom of Solomon 6 and 16, Salapia. So Wisdom of Solomon 6 verse 16 says, "For she goeth about seeking such as are worthy of her, speaking of wisdom, showeth herself favorably unto them in the ways, and meeteth them in every thought." You see? Every thought, wisdom is supposed to be meeting us, man. You know, and at the end of the day, you know, that's why this worldly wisdom, it's foolishness with the Most High, man. All right. It's the wisdom of the scriptures that are going to keep us stable. The scripture says, "Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of our times, man. All right. And the strength of our salvation." This is 1 Corinthians 3 and verse 19. It says, "For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High. For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness," man. And you see? So let me actually start up. It says, "Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seemeth to be wise in this world, let him become a fool that he may be wise." All right? So hey, if you wise, if you got wisdom of this world but not wisdom of the scriptures, at the end of the day, you know, you're not going to survive in the time of Jacob's trouble. You know? Agree with thine adversary quickly, man. And a lot of people today, they got too much pride to do that. Even members within this faith, they have too much pride to agree with thine adversary. They want to seem mighty, or the Lord dealing with me, you know? Hey, if you, hey, how did the Lord do? All right, he presented his body as a living sacrifice, man. All right, he said he had the power to, quoted. Yeah, this is Matthew 26. And verse 53. I'm going to start at 52. Matthew 26 and verse 52. "Then said Yahweh Shai unto him, put up again thy sword into his place. For all they that take the sword shall perish with the sword. Thinkest thou that I cannot now pray to my father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels?" You see? You know, but the Lord, he understood that prophecy needed to take place. All right? He was using wisdom. It says, verse 54, "But how then shall the scripture be fulfilled, that thus it must be? In that same hour said Yahweh Shai to the multitudes, are ye come out as against a thief with swords and staffs to take me? I sat daily with you teaching in the temples, and ye laid no hold on me. But all this was done that the scriptures might, that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled. Then all the disciples forsook him and fled." You see? So the Lord, he was fulfilling prophecy, man. All right, he understood that prophecy had to be fulfilled, you know? So he didn't take powers into his own hands. All right, didn't he wanted to go through that? No, but he had to, okay? And he understood the will of the Heavenly Father, you see? And we got to, hey, we got to take on that same mindset, man. Right, if you get caught up in a sticky situation, all right, just rely on the Lord. Don't try to act carnal Don't try to overtake the police, man. All right? Agree with thine adversary. Use wisdom. All right? We have the upper hand at the end of the day because we have wisdom. All right? So, really, I just wanted to make a quick exhortation on that. I saw that, and, you know, that just proves that these worldly guys, they ain't got it, man. All right? They don't use wisdom. That's why they get killed in these streets. Let me actually go to that. I mentioned that we honor the curses at the beginning. This is Deuteronomy 28 and verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field. You see, yeah, he was in the city. All right, well, that Broward or whatever, you know, hey, he cursed in the city, man. All right, your proverb, you a nigga at the end of the day. And they see you a nigga with a little bit of money. Target's really on you, man. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field, man. No matter where you at, in the city, in the you in the suburbs, you in the country, all right? Or no matter what state or country you in, you still, at the end of the day, you're a nigga in their eyes, man. All right? And yeah, that was pretty much the point, you know? So with that, you know, Lord willing, this video was edifying. I'm going to close and give all the praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rakakodash, the honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone. Peace and mercy to the house of David. And to the next lesson, I say Shalom, and the Bible ball, Shalom.